So you're gonna color in your lime green area. Go ahead and start spreading it out with your finger like this. I'm gonna start on the blue. You guys catch up. I am going to be using the blue a little bit ways on the green. You see how I'm starting on the green line? Okay, try not to bend your paper. It's hard, but you can do it. Let's keep going. We're gonna add black in, guys. Okay, you guys should have black also. Okay, when you're using the black, I want you to guys to use the flat part. So you're gonna paint, you're gonna draw with this part down, like that. It's fine, just keep going. Same thing, flat part, and then you're coloring, okay? I want a dark blue, like a sky dark blue, a deep blue. I'm gonna do a few lines of blue over here. You can put less pressure with your middle finger and it'll still actually blend really well. Okay, I'm gonna do streaks of blue. They're not straight. And then I'm gonna blend it. I like it better when I blend it with my middle finger. It looks nicer though. Following the blue streak all the way to the top in circles, and it blends really well. We do not want a dark blue line in our green. Let's stick with the black. I like the black. Let's go with black for the hills, okay? I am just doing straight lines all the way down to create a mountain shape. I am going with straight lines to do this. This is gonna be my first layer of black. And then I'm going to layer on top of it with some white. Okay, I'm gonna use my black and I'm gonna use my brown for this. You guys all got a brown. Okay, this like burnt sienna brown. And you can do this on top of the black. Yeah, black and then a burnt sienna on top of it. This will blend in with the black really well. No. Okay, white highlights. Okay. White highlights.